Hello, welcome to Accounting Hub. I'm Professor George Scarpin, PhD in accounting, and our topic today is goodwill, according to the US GAAP. So what is goodwill? Represents the unique value of a company as a whole over and above its identifiable, tangible, and intangible assets. So goodwill can emerge from a company's clientele and reputation, trained employees, favorite business location, branding, and so on. And it is not accountable. So that's why we have the goodwill. Because goodwill can't be separated from a company, it is not possible for a buyer to acquire it without also acquiring the whole company as a portion of it. How do we capitalize the cost of goodwill? Fair value of the consideration given in exchange for the company, our acquisition price, less the fair value of the identifiable net assets acquired. The fair value of all identifiable tangible and intangible assets other than goodwill, less fair value of any liabilities of the selling companies assumed. So it is the fair value of the net assets. So tangible plus intangible assets less liabilities. Before we talk about goodwill impairment, let's go to our Excel file to record the goodwill. So our Excel file, they are free and the link to download it is in our video description. So here, the Scarpin Corporation in January 2021 acquired all of the outstanding common stock of the Santiago Corporation, Scarpin Corporation, my fake company. Santiago is the last name of my wife, so in family here. In exchange for $300 million cash. So here, our cash, $380 million. Okay? And the goodwill is the sum of fair value less, or the sum of cash less the net assets. Okay, we don't know yet how much is the net asset, but it is the sum of these two here. Okay, Scarpin assumed all of the Santiago long-term liability, which have a fair value of $170 million. So liability, $170 million. And we record it, so we will assume it, so it will increase Scarpin's liability. So our journal entry here is Scarpin liability, $170 million. Okay? So what do we have? What else? The fair value of all identifiable assets of Santiago are follows. Receivable, 80. That is our debit because we will be adding it. So the fair value of the assets will be the sum of the assets here, but goodwill. Oh, and by the way, cash is our total here. And the goodwill, another way to find it, is the number to balance these journal entries. So the sum of credits less the sum of debits. So far, our goodwill is for 70. And what else? Inventory, 90 million. So it is 380. So 380. So far, so good. Inventory, 90 million. Property, plant, and equipment, 230. And here it is negative sum. Okay, now we're good. Goodwill, 150. Goodwill, 150. And patent, 70 million. 70 million here. So 470 is our assets. less 170 our the fair value of liability, so 300. We paid 380, net assets 300, so the goodwill is 80. So we debit goodwill here. Okay, so goodwill is the number to balance the journal entry of our acquisition. Let's go to our impairments. A level of testing is the reporting unit. And we consider here that Santiago is a reporting unit because reporting unit is an operating segment of a company or a component of an operating segment for which discrete financial information is available. So it is another company here. And segment management regularly reviews the operating results of that company. And for purpose of impairment testing, we compare the value of the reporting unit itself with its book value. If the fair value of the reporting unit is less than its book value, an impairment loss is indicated. And how much? The impairment loss is the amount by which the fair value exceeds the book value. However, the recognized loss can't exceed the book value of the goodwill. Of course, we cannot have a negative goodwill. It doesn't make sense to have a negative goodwill. So, impairment loss, the maximum in our Excel file is $80 million. If goodwill is tested for impairment at the same time as other assets of the reporting units, the other assets must be tested first, and any impairment losses are recorded prior to testing goodwill. So first we test, like our company here, first we test receivables, inventory, property, plant and equipment, especially property, plant and equipment, and patent. And the last one is goodwill. And IFRS is not on this order, it's the opposite order. So that's why this video is only for US GAAP. And subsequent reversal, recovery of a previous goodwill impairment loss is not allowed. In the US, IFRS, you can reverse it. Okay, so let's consider it. At the end of 2021, events and circumstances indicate that it's more likely than not that the fair value of Santiago, you don't have this A here, is less than its book value, requiring SRP to perform the goodwill test. Goodwill impairment test, sorry. The book value of Santiago net asset at the end of 2021 is now $400 million. And the impairment loss here, it is fair value less book value. So far we have $400 million. On that value, on that day, the fair value of Santiago is estimated in $370 million. So we have here a loss $30 million. What is our journal entry? Loss on impairment of goodwill and credit goodwill. So now, goodwill, we have a ending balance of $50 million. Okay, and here, the book value, we must include the goodwill because then we will be able to compare. So the net asset without goodwill, 320, we add the $80 million of goodwill, then it is $400 million. Okay, guys, subscribe our channel. You will be the first one to know when a new video arrives. Like our Facebook page, Accounting Hub by Dr. Scarpin. And thank you so much for watching this video. If you have questions or comments, leave it here or email me at jscarpin@gmail.com. Have a nice day and God bless you.